السلام عليكم. صلى الله على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. صلى الله على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. Let's continue with Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم stories. Today let's go through his childhood. After Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم was born, Abdul Muttalib took the newborn baby to the Kaaba for Allah's blessings and he named him Muhammad. It was a very unique name at that time. During that time, people of Makkah let their newborn babies live with their babysitter, who lived in the desert area that made the babies stronger and healthier. Those babysitters had the most purest form of Arabic language. It also helps the babies to learn the best Arabic language. Once some babysitters from Banu Sa'd tribe came to Makkah to choose the babies. Halima was in the group. They were very poor. They had a very weak donkey, so they were far behind the rest of the group. Abdul Muttalib asked every babysitter to take care of baby Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but they knew that he couldn't pay him, so they refused him. They were busy taking care of rich people's children. Halima was very late to reach Makkah, so she couldn't find any of the rich people's children. So she took baby Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam with her. However, she did not want to go back home without a baby. From that moment, their life changed instantly. The weak donkey started to run fast to Halima's house. Their animals started to give lots of milk and there was no more hunger in her family. Even during the very dry season, their animals gave lots of milk. For Halima, it was very easy to take care of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. She was very happy with him. Halima breastfed Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam until he was 2 years old. Every 6 months, Halima took Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to Makkah to see his family. She requested his mother to keep him a little longer as their family was happy with Halima for taking good care of their baby. When Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was 6 years old, his mother Amina wanted to visit Medina where his father died. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his grandfather Abdul Muttalib, his mother Amina and the slave Umm Ayman started their journey to Medina. It was around 500 kilometers of their journey. They stayed there around 1 month and then started their journey back to Makkah. At the middle point, his mother Amina became very sick and died. She was buried over there. The little boy Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam lost his mother and father and had become an orphan. His grandfather Abdul Muttalib took care of him for the next 2 years. When he was 8 years old, his grandfather Abdul Muttalib died. He became very sad without his father, mother and grandfather. His uncle Abu Talib was poor but was happy to take care of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam's miracle started his young age. When he was 12 years old, his uncle Abu Talib took him to Syria for a business trip. When they were entering the city of Bosra, a priest saw the trees and stones bent at the young boy. He was surprised to see that. He knew that trees and stones only bend down towards prophets. When they were taking a rest, the priest came towards Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and held his hand and told that he would be a future prophet and would bring kindness to all people. Abu Talib was surprised to hear this. He asked, how did he know that? The priest replied that he had the knowledge from the Bible. He also mentioned that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam has a seal of prophethood below his shoulders. He also requested Abu Talib to send him back for his safety because if someone found that information, they might kill him. Abu Talib immediately sent him back to Makkah with some of his trusted people. Thank you for watching. Rest, we will be continuing in another episode. Hope you guys enjoy my video. Please remember to like, share and subscribe to my channel and click the bell button. See you next time. Bye.